By the way, you did a great job playing Diana. And no bullshit. I mean, they're really talking about you're an early contender for the Oscar.
I know.
Which is great.
That's the first time in my life. It's dope. Yeah.
I mean, you've probably done what? About 50 some odd films. And now they're talking about you for an Oscar. And we want this fucking thing, right? I mean, I want it. I mean, I want it for you. Right? Yeah. What's the fantasy? You're not one of those people who's not going to show up at the Oscars. You want this thing.
Yeah, dude, totally. I think...
good.
It's like sometimes you watch the show over the course of being alive and watching the Oscars every year. Sometimes you're like, why do people win these things? They're not always like the best performances. You know what I mean? It is sort of very zeitgeisty, kind of like what's the temperature in the room? Because it is voted, like Academy members vote for the thing, people win. But then you're like, it does say something about like the times as well. It's not necessarily, and also to whatever, to sort of like pin performances against each other and creative endeavors against each other. It does sort of go against the whole idea of what art is. But at the same time, I'm like, yeah, for sure, I want to be a part of this conversation. I want everyone to see this movie. I'm so proud of it. Like, you know, it's kind of once in a lifetime thing. I just don't think this will ever happen again. So I'm kind of just, you know, I'm smooth sailing through this one.
Would it be out of line for me to request that when you give your Academy Award speech, maybe you remember your old friend Howard and, you know, drop his name in there somehow. You know what I mean? What do you think?
What list does he go on?
Yeah, I mean, I'd like a thank you. Why not?
Maybe the last thing I say is like, Howie, you were right.
Yes.
And there you go.